those brakes fixed, Cactus. Tired of overshooting this town.
We need a new car, Sheriff.
Well, the county just might give us one. I think we're going to attract a lot of attention booking this fella.
Okay, Bartlett, come on, let's go. Come on, let's go.
I'm suing you for false arrest.
Yeah, and I'm booking you on suspicion of murder.
Cancel my reservation. Please, Mr. Ticket Man. No time for explanation. But I'm gonna stay right where I am.
All right, get the cuffs off him, Cactus. Valuable. Come on, young fella. I'm gonna have to ask you a few questions. What's your name?
Wallet.
Dan Bartlett.
Dan Bartlett.
Don't know where it started, don't know why. All I know is that we had a quarrel and it ended with goodbye. Yeah!
Money?
Yeah, what do you do?
I'm on TV. Keith?
Nationality?
New Yorker.
Cancel my reservation. Please, Mr. Ticket Man.
Age?
42.
Mel?
Sex?
Yeah.
Sex?
Yeah.
Made my mind up, soon my bags were packed. All I needed was a one-way ticket, cause I'm never going back. Yeah!
All right, lock him up, Cactus.
Come on.
Hey, wait a minute. I'm entitled to one phone call.
Okay, if somebody phones you, I'll let you know.
Cancel the reservation. Please, Mr. Ticket Man. No time for explanation.
Come on. In here.
If you're wondering what a nice guy like me is doing in a place like this, well, it started because I was stuck in a place like this. The fellow who said people need people had obviously never been stuck in the Long Island Parkway at rush hour. Must be the mating season for barracudas. That's my car. It's last year's model. It was this year's before I got on the parkway.
What's the matter? You late for your accident? I fought that traffic 5 days a week to get to my TV show. When I wasn't fighting traffic, I was fighting with my wife, Sheila.
Dan, why did you have to use the parkway?
It's cheaper than getting shock treatments. Besides, you told me to.
You never listened to me. Why did you pick today?
Well, my horoscope said this is the day to repair broken friendships. So I thought I'd start with ours.
You have been so uptight since I've been doing the show.
I was happier when you were home.
Well, I wasn't. I enjoy working. And I have a right to establish my own identity.
Well, thank you, Martha Mitchell.
Don't know where it started, don't know why. All I know is that we had a quarrel and it ended with goodbye.
Don't worry about her. She always comes back. She has to. We're on TV in a couple of hours.
And now, here they are, America's sweethearts, Dan and Sheila Burton.
I had one of the most popular talk shows on the air. Even Johnny Carson stayed up to watch it. One night, as Sheila was waiting backstage to drive me home, I asked her to come out and take a bow. That was 6 months ago, and she's still bowing. This was the most popular part of the show. We'd give advice to people who wrote in with problems. We were well qualified to do this because we couldn't solve our own.
Dan, do you think today's young people are ready for marriage?
I think they should be. The ones I've seen in drive-in movies have been practicing for years. Our guest today is a black belt karate expert, Mr. Yamamoto. I understand that you've written a book on karate, Mr. Yamamoto.
Yes.
Mm. Karate for Lovers and Other Strangers.
That's a very unusual title. How did you arrive at that?
I teach karate to to robbers who worry about strangers mugging them in parks.
Oh, that's fascinating. You care to give us a sample?
Demonstration is worth 1,000 words.
Oh, I learned a little about this from my daddy. He used to be a police detective.
Now, you are two robber walking through park. I am mugger. I sneak up behind you. I say, your money or your wife. What do you do?
Well, I'd give you Sheila and notify your next of kin.
For purpose of demonstration, you decide to protect wife.
Oh, is this karate or science fiction?
Now, hear what you do. This is called robber's swing. Swing hands forward. Swing hands backward. Swing hands forward and back very sharply.
Very good.
Now you finish job like this. Here. You be mugger. Mm-hmm. Now, while you standing with the mouth open in surprise, wishing you had picked a little old lady, and lady use free hand to bread basket.
Oh, wait.
Sorry, Dad. Oh, I have just the thing for you. Tummy tones for tummy distress.
Thank you. Hey, you've been wonderful. Yes. Will you come back again sometime? Wish we had more time.
We had.
Thank you. That's it for today. We hate to leave you, but you stay well and have a wonderful, wonderful weekend. Thank you. Yes, Trace. We'll see you. I'm glad that's over.
Dad, I didn't hit you on purpose. My lover swing slipped.
Yeah, I suppose that was a slip, you belling me in the stomach with those tummy tones.
You deserved it, making it sound like you didn't want me on the show.
Shh. Tummy tones isn't going to want either one of you on the show if you don't stop fighting.
He's fighting. He's jealous of my success.
Why don't you go help Dick Cavett?
That's gratitude. After boosting your rating.
It'd be higher if I could work alone.
Oh, it's really not his fault, Mr. Sparker. He's just nervous and irritable and impossible. I've been trying to get him to see a doctor for months, but he insists there's nothing wrong with him.
There is now. My navel used to be in front. After a complete examination, my doctor prescribed two things. A vacation alone for me and $75 for him.
Vacation without my wife. Who am I going to fight with?
Look, you need a complete rest and a change of scenery, and your wife is part of the scenery.
Yeah, but what about our show?
I've seen your show, and I'm sure she can handle it alone. Besides, she looks a lot cuter than you do in a miniskirt.
You know, you're even funnier than Marcus Welby.
I don't care if the doctor did tell you to get away. You don't have to go to Phoenix alone.
But you're the one who told me to go to the doctor.
Well, I just thought he'd give you some medicine.
He thought getting away from you was better than medicine.
Hey, Mr. Bartlett.
Yeah?
Can I have your autograph?
Yeah, sure.
Now you're saying I'm responsible for you being sick.
No, no. He didn't mean sick, sick. He just meant we're sick of each other.
Well, we could have talked about it. You don't have to just pack up and rush off like this.
Now you say that.
Mr. Bartlett, may I have your autograph?
You're going alone to our little ranch house.
Yeah,
it's for my mother. She's been a fan of yours since I was a little girl.
It's bad enough that you're leaving, but the way you're leaving, just with everything up in the air.
Yeah, but I'll
hey,
call
you
in. We'll...
Hey, you. Are you anybody?
Sure, I'm Raquel Welch. I always look like this between pictures.
Let's go, Josie. He's some kind of wise guy.
Oh, he's just kidding, girls. That's Dan Bartlett.
Dan who?
Bartlett! He's on television!
Oh, television. Well, goody for you. Come on, Trudy, let's get out of here.
If you ever make a movie, just let us know.
They're lovely kids. I've never seen a better argument for the pill.
Can you tell me if... Excuse me, miss. Is that the plane the senator's on?
Somebody tell us.
What's that?
Tough luck, fellas. The senator isn't on this plane.
Hey, well, I do. Hey, it's Dan Bartlett.
That's right.
But I just think it was nice of you to show up for my entrance here.
We're waiting for the senator. He was going to give us a statement on the Indians.
Well, I say the Indians better get a new pitcher. They'll never win the pennant.
We're talking about the Indians taking over the government land.
You mean like Alcatraz?
Right.
Well, yeah. Well, what do you think?
Oh, we shouldn't mind sharing Alcatraz with the Indians. After all, we're sharing Washington with the Redskins.
Seriously, Dan.
Well, I feel if the land belongs to the Indians, they should keep it. Haven't we taken enough away from them?
Mr. Bartlett?
Huh?
May I speak to you?
Dan, let me catch you something.
Very urgent.
Dan, will you walk toward me?
Yeah.
Mr. Bartlett, please.
Well, okay, honey. What's on your mind?
Not here. There's something I have to show you.
Well, in that case, come out to my place tomorrow. We can be alone. Oh, and bring a chaperone. I'd hate to get in trouble with the Department of the Interior. I spent the night in a hotel and arranged for a maid to clean up the house before I moved in. The Arizona air felt marvelous. It was great to do something I didn't do in New York. Breathe. Maybe with 2 weeks of clean air, I'd be strong enough to go home and liberate Sheila right off the show. The house looked a little older than it did 10 years ago, but then again, who didn't? I guess the maid that was sent here traveled economy class.
Hello? I'm here.
One thing I could say about this maid, she wasn't nosy. Must be the dry season.
Hello, you in here? Hey, wake up. Sleep on your own time. Hey.
It was the girl at the airport. From the bullet hole in her back, the blood, and the fact that she wasn't breathing, I assumed she was dead. Connected yet. I couldn't call the sheriff. The next best thing was to get him. I went back to the bedroom to get my car keys out of my coat. The fellow who called the Indian the vanishing American wasn't kidding. I figured the only thing I could do now was to hightail it for the sheriff. In New York, you'd get the police, but in the West, you hightail it for the sheriff. I didn't like the way my vacation was starting. I didn't like finding bodies that got up and walked away. I could have imagined the whole thing. The doctor did say my nerves were shot. I figured the best thing to do was to go back and take a nap. I came to Arizona for a rest.
Mighty nifty U-turn you made back there, mister.
I'm sorry. I'm in kind of a hurry.
That kind of a hurry will get you into the morgue. Let me see your license. Dan Bartlett. Hey, you look familiar.
Yeah, I'm Dan Bartlett. I do a television show with my wife.
Is that her back there?
No, that's just a girl I found in my bedroom.
Hey, she's dead, mister.
bother me with your problems. I'm working on an alibi.
How could I have killed her? When I walked in here, she was lying there dead.
What did you do after that, besides hide the murder weapon?
I didn't have a weapon. I don't like guns. They bother me. I rushed right to the phone to call you.
How come you didn't get me?
How come I didn't get you? Because the phone's not connected. I'm sorry, the phone's not connected. Well, it wasn't then. Then I hopped in my car to get to you.
Yeah. You want to know what show you're watching?
Let's make a deal.
All right, what did you do after you tried to get me on the phone that wasn't connected, that's connected?
I told you, I went to the bedroom to get my car keys.
Hello, Doc.
Well, what's the report, Doc?
The deceased was an unidentified Indian girl, early 20s. Vital statistics, 5'5", 105 weight, 34, 24, 45.
45?
That was the bullet.
Time of death?
1:33¾.
Well, now, you were here at 1 o'clock. I'd give you plenty of time to do the job.
How can you be so sure of the exact time of her death?
Her watch broke when she hit the floor.
Or when you hit her.
I never hit a girl in my life.
It's always the first time.
I didn't kill her. When I returned to the bedroom, the body was gone.
Sure, she got up and walked to your car, right?
That's right. I didn't say that. I went to report it to you.
Report what?
The body.
You said you didn't have one.
I had one, but it disappeared.
I don't believe you.
That's why I changed my mind about telling you.
Well, you can't do that. It's against the law not to report a body, even if you don't have one.
No trace of the murder weapon yet, Sheriff.
And you won't find one. I never owned a gun in my life.
What's this?
It's an antique. It came with the house.
Wrong bore anyway, Tom. She was killed with a .45.
So you didn't know her, huh?
Oh, yeah, that was at the airport. See, she said she had something that she was dying to tell me. I mean, she said it was a matter of life and death. And so I told her to come out here so we could be alone. And, I couldn't believe all this was happening to a nice guy like me. It was like Billy Graham being arrested for bookmaking.
Before letting you go, boy, let me just get back the lab report.
You mean you didn't find my fingerprints on the girl?
Oh, that's a pretty fast one.
Yeah, you lock me up again, you'll have a very fast lawsuit.
Well, I'm sorry about that, Mr. Bartle, but we just had to make sure. No hard feelings. Hope you have a nice stay.
Yeah. Hey, and check that mattress. I wasn't lonesome.
It was a mistake to let him go, Sheriff.
Well, I got no case on him.
I still think he's our man.
So do I. We'll just have to keep our eye on him till he leads us to that murder weapon.
It was 3 a.m. when I got back to my little gray home in the West. Some vacation. Now, if I could just get that dead girl off my mind, I could make it to dreamland.
Partner, you don't have your brand on that yet.
You're alive.
Only one of us is gonna be if you make another move.
Who are you?
That's my question, stranger.
I ask you first.
But I got the gun.
Don't you know it's against the law to carry a concealed weapon?
I'm not wearing anything to conceal it in.
Yeah, well, skip the technicalities. You're in my bed.
Oh, hey, you must be the daddy bear of this cave.
I'm Dan Bartlett, and I'm not as bare as you are.
Sure, the TV pitch man. Sorry about that. I thought you hopped in here to do a little rustling.
I'm too tired to do that kind of rustling. So whoever you are, will you clear out so I can get some sleep?
I'm Crazy Hollister.
Yeah, I'm not too sane myself.
That's my nickname. Well, now that we know each other better, do you mind if I get sack out for the night?
Wait a minute. Don't you have a home?
Sure, Strawberry Ranch.
The Strawberry?
Mm-hmm.
You own 50,000 acres and you sleep here?
Mm-hmm.
That's like Onassis traveling by canoe.
I sleep here whenever I fight with my stepfather, which is most of the time.
Why don't you write to Dear Abby? I'm here for rest, no excitement.
I even canceled my subscription to Playboy. So you better leave.
You're gonna hate yourself in the morning.
I hate myself now.
Where are you going?
To the sofa.
What are you gonna do there?
Cry myself to sleep. Can't even sleep in my own bed. I've heard of strangers in the night, but this is ridiculous. I had to leave New York for this.
I could go for a cup of black coffee. How about you?
Just what I need to put me to sleep.
I brought some potato chips, too.
Chew quietly. I'm a light sleeper.
I get it.
No. Oh, no, you don't. Wait a minute. You get back in that bedroom and take that blanket off. I mean, put on some clothes.
Well, the Avon lady was spurs.
Just happened to be in the neighborhood.
You can't come in here without a search warrant. What are you searching for this time?
Same thing as before, the murder weapon.
Look, why don't you get bright and give up?
Now, folks, don't call me Houndtooth Riley for nothing. Once I sink my teeth into someone, I just never let go. And one day soon, I'm going to bite you, Mr. Bartlett, and I'm going to bite you real hard.
Easy, I haven't had my distemper shot.
Well, that's a pretty good idea, sleeping out here. I imagine that room back there has got some pretty disturbing vibrations in.
If you want to search, go ahead and search. I'm going to get some sleep. I haven't had any sleep in about...
You can go ahead and sleep if you want to, but I'm not going to sleep.
Drop it!
Huh?
Drop that gun. Drop it! Drop it! Get up! And no more of that fancy shooting. Look, Sheriff,
What happened?
You know this fella?
We just met.
Well, you ought to be more choosy about the people you associate with, Miss Hollister. This fella tried to kill me.
I did not.
Well, then what was that tricky saddle shot?
It was an accident. I happened to sit on the gun.
You were trying to hide that gun.
Oh, you're... Well,
.45. Same caliber as killed that girl.
I didn't kill her.
Well, then why are you trying to hide that gun?
Because I figure you'd think just what you're thinking.
Well, you stop trying to think what I'm thinking. I don't think that way at all.
You thought I hit a body when I didn't. Why'd you think that?
Because that's the way I think. I've got to think like that to keep one jump out of somebody who thinks the way you do.
He couldn't kill anybody. He's harmless. I ought to know.
Oh, thanks a pile.
You better stay out of this, Miss Hollister. If that proves to be the murder weapon, it's going to hang you, Mr. Bartlett. Hello. Cactus. Wake up! Yeah, now go on down and open the jail. I'm bringing in a killer. Wake up.
I told you, I never saw that gun before. I picked it up
and shot me.
And shot you.
Will you come on?
I didn't mean to. It just went off.
Yeah, well, it was a 50-cent cigar.
Here's a dollar. Buy two.
You think you can buy me for a buck?
I was going to ask for a change.
All right, Cactus, lock him up.
Wait a minute. Hold it. What's this bull about arresting that man for murder?
John is.
Know who he is? Dan Bartlett, the television star.
You see?
Yeah, but, John, just because he's a TV star doesn't mean that he didn't kill anybody.
You're going to be sheriff of this town. You've got to learn to size a man up better than that. Look at that face. That's not the face of a murderer. Look at those eyes. He's got soft eyes. You got soft eyes, you got a soft gut.
I resent that, I think.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Bartlett. I've always enjoyed your show.
Thanks. You're not only the first sane person I've met, you also have good taste.
You gotta excuse the sheriff. He's kind of new at the job. And he's not gonna have any chance to grow older in it if he keeps making these mistakes.
John Ed, I found this man...
I remember the law, Mr. Bartlett. He's gotta let you go unless he brings you before a judge within 48 hours and charges you.
Now, you know I can't do that, John Ed. Judge Kimbrough's up at the lodge trout fishing.
Yeah, well, you better let me out of here. I'll bring a firm of lawyers in here with a name longer than this town.
Let them go, Riley. Town doesn't want a damn fool for a sheriff. And I know. I'm the town.
All right, you're free.
Bye.
But you're still under suspicion, so don't leave this town.
I may have to. It's only 50 feet long.
John Ed doesn't think you did it, but I'm going to find a new motive. Before Judge Kimbrough gets back in this town, I'm going to charge you with murder.
The envelope, please.
Thank you. Come here. I want to talk to you.
Okay, I'm here. Talk.
You were lucky, young lady. You could have wound up in jail last night.
Not much difference between jail and here. Except maybe the company's a little better.
Keep a respectful tongue in your head, miss. What were you doing at the Bartlett Ranch?
I don't have to answer to you. You've got no hog
tied. I'm responsible for you till you're 30 years old.
You've got my money hog tied, not me.
Oh, it's you. I didn't recognize you with your clothes on.
Howdy, pitch man. How'd you get out of jail?
Your stepfather sprung me.
Oh?
What are you doing here?
I just came by to pick up some of the clothes.
Hey, what have you got against John Ed? Any fellow likes my show can't be all bad.
Oh, well, I never liked John Ed from the moment my mother married him. And after she was killed in that accident. Hey, I came by to get my clothes, not to give you a daytime cereal.
Want a cup of coffee?
Okay.
I don't want you to think I was giving you a rough time last night. It's not that I don't like pretty girls, but I have a wife in New York who's...
Dad!
Not in New York.
Honey? Came as soon as I heard you were in trouble.
Boy, am I in trouble.
I heard the story on the news. Who could be stupid enough to think that you would murder anyone?
Well, you know, circumstantial evidence.
Well, I know you're innocent.
Well, I... Yeah, I'm innocent. All I want you to know is I want you in my arms, this way, for the rest of my life.
Oh, that fresh air has done a lot for you.
Oh, you know what I was telling you about? Circumstantial evidence?
Mrs. Bartlett, there's really nothing to this. Your husband told me he was married the minute I met him.
Yeah, I hopped right out of bed.
One consolation. I won't have to divorce you. I'll just wait until they hang you.
Mrs. Bartlett, I live at Strawberry Ranch. I've just been sleeping over because nobody was living here.
That's the honest truth.
It sounds honest. It's just that you're not built honest.
There are plenty of mavericks on the range. I don't have to husband wrestle. Besides, there aren't many people in this town who believe your husband's innocent. You're gonna need a friend.
Okay. Friend.
Well, if you need me, you can catch me at Strawberry. Bye.
Bye. Well, I'll unpack and we'll get to work.
Get to work.
Oh, we have to clear you, and fast.
Why, if they hang me, you can have the show all to yourself.
Dan, I'm glad you haven't lost your sense of humor.
Sparker has. He says your Tummy Tone's image has been soured.
What happened to the show? We still on?
Yes. Bing Crosby's sitting in for us next week.
Bing who? Oh, him. Yeah. It'll take us weeks to get the orange pits out of the studio.
Don't be nasty. Hope we can clear you. Barker banned you from the air until we do.
How could anybody think I murdered that girl? I'm innocent.
I know that.
Thanks, honey.
How come you found a girl in your bedroom and not a man?
Will you stop being a wife? I need a lawyer.
How good will a lawyer do? We have to find out who really did it.
Sheila, this is a job for professionals.
Why? My daddy was the ace homicide man at his precinct, at least until he was shot.
He was an ace, all right, but I spelled it differently.
Don't worry. Daddy taught me everything he knew. Now, how did that body get out of this bedroom into the car?
Somebody had to move it.
Daddy always said there are two things a dead body doesn't do, talk and walk.
All right, Mrs. North, if you're so smart, who moved?
The real murderer, of course. You came home and you surprised him.
Hey, wait a minute. The window was open. And the curtains were billowing like this. And he could have been hiding right outside the window. When I went to the phone, he could have climbed in and carried the body out of the window.
Well, if he went to all the trouble of dragging the body outside, why would he put it in your car?
Well, that comes from being a celebrity. People are always doing nice things for you.
Like pinning a murder rap on you.
Yeah, well, if you want to do that, he could have left the body right here where it was.
Look, I picked this up at the airport. The dead girl's name was Mary Little Cloud, an American Indian, died of a bullet wound from a .45 caliber revolver. No indication of rape. That clears you with me.
Will you find something that clears me with a sheriff?
Listen, she is survived by her uncle, Joe Little Cloud. Now, here's the man we have to find.
Joe Little Cloud, with a name like that, we'll probably find him at the Weather Bureau.
Pollution.
What do you want?
A bike.
What bike? The bike Mary Little Cloud rode the day you killed her.
Hey, wait a minute. Do I look like a murderer?
You don't look like a comedian, but you are one.
Look, we're trying to find out who killed your friend. Now, maybe you can help us.
We just want the bike. It belongs to one of our friends.
It was impounded by the sheriff. Hey, do you know where I can find Joe Little Cloud?
What if we do?
Will you take us there?
Okay, hop on.
Yeah, you hop on. I'll follow you in a cab.
Hop on, chicken.
How does he know?
Stop at the first insurance machine, will you? Finish this freeway. Oh! Yeah. We can pick up my stomach on the way back.
Mary had only friends, not enemies.
When'd you last see your niece?
Oh, on the moon of the shedding horse.
What is that in daylight saving time?
Last month.
Why don't you say that in the first place?
Excuse the Indian lingo, but I work at the trading post, and the tourists, they expect us to be colorful. Please, sit down.
When you last saw her alive, did you notice anything different about her? Like, was she nervous or upset?
She was heavy of heart. She said she had found something important for our people, but could do nothing.
Did she tell you what it was?
No. Mary just said that Roscoe Snagby, he's the land recorder in Little Bend, wasn't helpful to her.
Did she say anything else?
No. Yes. She said she wanted to tell Senator what she found after he came back from meeting of Great White Council.
White Council?
Congress.
Oh, that's what she was doing at the airport. The senator was supposed to be on my plane.
Well, she must have said something to that fella Snagby. Let's see what he knows about it. Thank you, Mr. Cloud.
Wait. There is a man who knows more. Old man who lives in Bear Cave, who sits before fire and has much wisdom.
What's his name?
Old man who live in Bear Cave, who sits before fire and has much wisdom.
No middle initial? He must have a very long mailbox. What do you call him for short?
Old Bear.
You are colorful. Why should we talk to him?
Old Bear knows all. He's 110 years old. He has power no one else has.
Dad? I bet Old Bear's a psychic.
Old Bear knows when the rains come, when the crops grow, and who will be born and who will die.
Dad,
knows all that from looking into the fire?
Yeah, and he also watches Rona Barrett. Look, I don't believe in that psychic jazz.
Well, you don't have any choice. Unless you want me to be a rich widow.
Yeah, you've just convinced me. But where does Old Bear hang out?
It isn't too hard to find Old Bear, but you'll have to wait. I'll take you there. After the moon of the deep water.
Look, I can't wait. They're trying to pin a murder rap on me.
You go now and you go alone. I'm going to wait for the new moon.
Just tell us where to go.
You'll need my horses.
Joe Little Cloud was right. Old Bear wasn't easy to find.
Okay.
I was sure of one thing. You have to let the horse know who is master. Obviously, this horse knows.
Oh, that's the way it's gonna be, huh?
Hey, Sheila was in great shape from riding an electric horse at her gym. But I hadn't been on a pony since I bet $20 on the fifth at Pimlico. Man, that's up there. 7,000 feet, and he has to have the penthouse. Old Bear had better know plenty, or he wasn't going to make it to 111. What a place for Howard Hughes to hide.
You think we're on the menu?
Hey, if you're waiting for us to drop in for lunch, you're mistaken, Ken.
He looks like he ate the whole thing.
Don't worry, we'll make it.
Oh, glad you're in good condition, honey.
The guy who said there was room at the top had probably never tried to reach Old Bear.
Must be a gas station around here somewhere.
Hey.
A long way to see you. They're gonna hang me for murder unless you can help me.
I love his sense of humor.
Me up and see you. I'm okay with yours.
Oh.
have a nice spa here. It's cool and airy.
Ah, kus na mi kwa chay ap no yap m si ay. Mne chap ta an stit na nat.
Get the sneaky feeling he doesn't speak English?
Yeah, I don't understand how a human can live to be 110 and not understand English. I know 3-year-old kids who speak English. I gotta try again. Old Bear, look, Joe Little Cloud sent us up here to see you. You were the one with all the wisdom, and you gotta help me because I'd like to get through to you, but I think I'm bombing. Old Bear, look, you gotta help me because I'm in trouble. I'm liable to fry if there's somebody does. I'm dependent. Old Bear, are you Old Bear or Georgie Jessel?
Oh.
One of us has to go back and get an interpreter.
Yeah, and on the way down, say hello to the vulture for me, will you? Okay. Here we go. Well, I was the one elected to go back for Joe Little Cloud. I figured it was safe to leave Sheila overnight with a 110-year-old man. On the other hand, if he could climb this cliff, he was capable of anything. Why'd you tell us that stream was 10 feet deep?
Well, if you remember when we saw each other last, I told you not to travel during the moon of the deep water, but you wouldn't wait. You wait for the new moon, and I'll go with you.
Why didn't you tell us Old Bear didn't speak English?
He didn't ask.
I guess he's got us, honey.
All right, when is the new moon?
In about 15 minutes.
Well, why don't you say so?
He didn't ask.
I'll never know how we got this country away from these people. Yeah. Back to the Old Bear Hill. Legs bend this way.
Naguncha. Seshkoi Pinda Bartlett Kohini Bartlett.
Tao Chunap Swatas Kuna Forward Kohi Swanath. Meskititan Snam.
What was that all about? Oh, you asked him what he could tell us about my niece's murder. He's now meditating.
Wake up. Old Bear will speak now.
Yeah? What day is it?
In Quartinuk the Mary, this one. Cryantus this month, not to Yeyul.
He says he sees Mary putting stones in fireplace. This is key to murder.
Stones? In a fireplace?
What fireplace?
We want to know who killed her.
And why?
Enchan Eos. Schwart Queen Goyot. Shanmas.
What he ate of Chinchunk, so he watching the jails. He took some
Old Bear says that's all he knows. He's too tired to concentrate more. Remember, he's 110 years old. Right now, who isn't?
24 hours climbing to the top of the Matterhorn, and what does he tell us? Look for rocks in a fireplace.
Well, he could know what he's talking about. He's psychic.
He's a fake.
How can he be a fake? Look how long he's made a living at it.
Rocks in the fireplace. I'll tell you what the rocks are. They're in our heads for... Hey, will you watch that stuff? You're gluing my eyelids together.
Oh, sorry, honey.
Let's see what the county recorder knows, huh?
We'd like to see the county recorder.
You're looking at him. Roscoe Snagby's the name.
Oh, we're happy to meet you, Mr. Snagby.
Oh, I'd like to ask you a few questions about Mary Little Cloud.
Mary Little Cloud? Oh, isn't she the gal I read about in the papers?
Yeah, I understand she came to visit you shortly before she was killed.
Well, when was that?
During the moon of the shedding horse.
That was last month.
Well, lots of folks come tromping through
Mr.
here.
Mr. Snagby. It'll help us find out who killed her.
Yeah, it might have something to do with land.
Say, it's 5 after 2.
Well, did she come here or didn't
I'm
she?
I'm sorry, folks. Wait the county recorder's office is closed for the day.
But we have more questions.
You come
to
back
ask.
Tomorrow. This is important. From 2 o'clock on, I'm the dog catcher.
Yeah, but we'd like
to. I'll see you.
This.
You come back now, you hear?
So I told the Bartletts that the county recorder's office was closed for the afternoon.
That was a very healthy thing to do.
Well, you've thrown a lot of things my way, John Ed. Of course, they're going to be back again tomorrow asking a lot more questions about Mary Little Cloud. Well, you just keep right on saying nothing. Well, that's going to be kind of hard to do, being a law-abiding citizen. Of course, now, if I was to start on a vacation...
Vacation, huh?
Yeah, always did want to go to Hawaii. Always heard about them hooligans and them grass skirts. Thought I'd get myself a lawnmower and have a little fun.
How much?
Well, considering I'd have to close down 5 of my income-bringing jobs, I'd say... $25,000?
Careful, Snagby. I don't think you need that much of a rest.
Mighty big strain on me knowing what I know. Any minute it could slip out how I called you and told you why Mary Little Cloud come to see me. And after that, she was found dead. Folks could get mighty suspicious about that coincidence.
Maybe you need more of a rest than I thought.
Excuse me, John Ed. There's a Mr. and Mrs. Bartlett out here to see you.
Tell them I'll be right with them. You can't be caught here. Reese will be right out with the money.
Thank you kindly, John Ed. I'll send you a postcard.
Reese.
I think you could use a permanent vacation.
Yeah.
Hank, send the Bartlett's in. You're all clear. Judge Kimbrough didn't come back, so the sheriff can't make you stay in town any longer.
Yeah, but I work for Tummy Tones, and I can't leave with a soured image. Besides, Tummy Tones isn't too thrilled about having a murder suspect selling their product. If they wanted violence, they'd sponsor the news.
You might be pushing your luck. If you head east on the next plane, this whole thing will blow over and be forgotten.
Well, Dan doesn't have to leave under a cloud. Not with the clues we dug up.
Oh? Isn't playing detective a little out of your line? Pushing tummy pills?
Oh, my daddy was a detective. He cracked the Brancusi murder case and the Morrissey case.
And while he was doing it, he cracked 2 cases of bourbon.
We got a lead from Mary Little Cloud's uncle. Now, she found something important that has to do with land, and she went to Snagby.
But we got the feeling he wasn't telling us everything he knows.
What makes you think so?
The minute we mentioned land, he switched from county recorder to dog catcher.
And the sheriff won't listen to Dan and me. But if you put pressure on him and you made him question Snagby, I bet we'll come up with a murderer.
You dead set on finding the murderer, huh?
Well, we're not going to budge from here until we clear Dan.
Yeah, what if he kills somebody else? Could even be me. Well, that'll be one way of clearing you. Nah, who'd want to hurt you?
Well, are you going to back us up with the sheriff?
Excuse me.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Why'd you do that?
Yeah, I'll back you up with the sheriff. You go to him right now and tell him what you just told me.
Didn't I tell you we could count on him?
Yes, thank you so much.
Not at all.
That's great, John Ed. Thank you.
Give my best regards to the sheriff.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Is he great? See ya.
Yeah. In about 30 years.
Hey, Riley. We got a clue for you.
I don't need no clues. I just need Judge Kimbrough to get back here so I can charge you.
Sheriff, I'm Mrs. Bartlett, and I don't like the way you've been persecuting my husband.
And I don't like people who bump off other people. I call that unfriendly.
I didn't bump anybody off. You convicted me because they happened to find a body in my car. I'd have to be pretty stupid to leave a body in my car. You don't think that I...
Get in there. Get in there.
All I want is a fair trial.
If it ever comes to trial. You know, the people in this town are mighty sore. Mob rule may prevail.
Mob rule? Wait a minute. Hey, wait a minute.
Hey.
What's the matter?
Sheila.
Hey, do something. Don't act like strangers. Wait a minute. Hey, help me. You know I'm innocent.
Help you? Who do you think bought the rope?
Isn't there any justice?
Poor fella, he'll do anything to win an Oscar.
Look, you people, you know who I am. You.
I'd like to help you, but it's not my picture.
Hey, you mean you're going to stand there and not lift a finger to help me?
What you see is what you get.
The devil made him do that.
What a way to get canceled.
And television celebrity Dan Bartlett has been arrested for a second murder.
You don't have to tell me what's happening, Sheila. It's on television every 15 minutes.
Yes, but what they didn't say is that Dan didn't do it.
Sheila, one body I can overlook, but two bodies?
Look, Willie, someone is trying to frame Dan. I'm half out of my mind.
I'm sorry about that, Sheila. If it goes to your stomach, take some tummy tones.
Thanks a lot, Willie. I'll call you tomorrow.
Well, he's a real pal. If you were drowning, he'd throw you a commercial. I just don't understand it. Imagine holding Dan in jail without bail. I just feel awful.
Don't blame yourself for that.
Well, it's my fault Dan didn't pack up and go home. I had to play detective.
Is that what's bugging you? Or is it the fact that it's your fault Dan came out here alone in the first place?
How'd you get the name Crazy?
I pinned it on myself. Until we come together inside, we're all a little crazy.
What do you mean by that? Come together.
Your mind and feelings gotta be on the same pony. Not riding off in different directions. Makes you crazy.
Sounds a little like Dan. His mind and his feelings aren't on the same pony. For instance, he knows that I've been a big help to him on the show, but he feels he'd rather have me at the house.
Most husbands feel that way about their wives. That's why I'd rather see than be one.
Are you anti-marriage?
A lot of couples use a license to take advantage of each other.
Oh, I've never taken advantage of Dan.
You sure?
Well, what if I have? I sat home alone for 9 years while he did the show. He was always in the city or off somewhere doing personal appearances. He had me stuck in the country. He'd just visit me from time to time. Even the visits didn't pay off. We still don't have any children.
That is kind of rough.
And I always believed in equal rights for women. So I just decided to get out and do my own thing.
Well, are you doing your own thing or are you boarding in on his?
Well, since I joined Dan on the show,
the rating's gone up. What about your bed rating? Sorry about that. But one of these days, when you two aren't playing Mr. and Mrs. in front of 30 million people, you're going to find yourselves alone someplace. And then you'll have to talk. That's the day when you'll find out where you're really at.
And when will that great day come?
Probably after a great night.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
Don't worry. It's just a coffee.
Sheila, look at these rocks. Didn't you say something about rocks in a fireplace?
That's what old Bear said to look for. They're in strange little piles.
Don't touch them. They're the rock signs the Indians use. We had an Indian foreman who taught me some of them.
A message in rock? Can you read it?
It's been a long time, but this is the sign for berry.
What kind of berry? I mean, the kind you eat it when you're 6 feet under.
Like blackberry or
strawberry. I bet she was trying to tell us something about Strawberry Ranch.
Maybe.
What do those rocks say?
Best I can make out is barrel.
Maybe it has something to do with a barrel of strawberries. Well, I'm sorry, Crazy. Maybe it has nothing to do with Strawberry Ranch at all.
Maybe so, maybe not.
Hello?
Mrs. Bartlett?
Yes.
This is Joe Littlecloud.
Oh, hello, Mr. Cloud.
I have an important message from old Bear. Now, I think he knows who the murderer is, but he won't tell me. Now, he wants to talk to Mr. Bartlett in person.
Well, he can't. Dan is in jail. Couldn't he tell me?
Aubert, nunce hancho kishta et Mrs. Bartlett.
How hawk one now, chung.
Hello?
Yes, what did he say?
Rough translation. Aubert doesn't make house calls.
Well, let's say Dan could get out of jail tonight.
Well, if so, then come to the garage in the second mesa. Aubert's visiting his nephew here.
Will you be there?
No, I'm working at the trading post tonight. But his nephew will translate. Ciao.
Ciao. Ciao. Crazy, I have to get... Crazy!
Kind of funny. Mrs. Bartlett said they only stopped 3 places the day they came out to see you. Snagby's, a gas station, and here. So Snagby's body had to be put in the car in one of those 3 places.
And you come around with a lot of loose talk about finding rocks in a fireplace.
Old Bear thinks those rocks will lead to the murderer.
What's that old fake got to do with this?
You may call him a fake, but he knew about those rocks being in the Bartlett's fireplace. And Mrs. Bartlett just heard on the phone that old Bear has another lead. I think the sheriff might be interested in this.
I think you ought to stay home and keep your nose clean.
How clean has yours been all these years, old man?
You're still blaming me for that accident?
You say it was an accident. You came back alive after that car ride, and my mother was dead. And you controlled Strawberry.
Why, you...
But you didn't count on ending up in a wheelchair, did you?
Rocks don't prove anything.
Our set of dead body tells stories. It's already written the name Strawberry. Next, I can write your name.
What do you mean?
Old Bear.
Not crazy, old Indian?
He knew all about the rocks and the fireplace. Now he's about to tell him something else.
Do you think he could really pin this on us?
Not us, Reese. You.
Hey, wait a minute. You're in this with me, old man, wheels and all.
If anything points to you, I'll be the first to turn you in. You won't do it, Reese. In case of accidental death, there's an envelope in my safe addressed to the sheriff of Wichita, Kansas. He just might be fascinated to know the man he's been looking to hang is now called Reese. I'd say you just better pray nothing unnatural ever happens to me.
All right, Bartlett, you got a visitor.
Oh, hi, honey.
Hi, darling.
I'll let you have a couple of minutes. I'll take that bag.
Oh, that goes well with your high heels.
Jail breaks tonight. Pass it.
Pass it? To who, the sheriff?
I have it all planned.
Are you out of your mind? It's illegal to break out of jail. I could get 5 years just for that alone.
Well, they're gonna hang you anyway. What's another 5 years?
Yeah, but I'm a law-abiding citizen. I want to hang with a clean record.
Oh, Dan, old Bear has a clue, and he'll only tell it to you.
I'd rather hang than climb that mountain again.
He's at his nephew's garage on the second mesa, and I'm gonna take you there.
I don't know.
Okay, time's up.
Oh, so soon, Sheriff. Have a heart. It's hard for lovers to say goodbye. Mm-hmm. We'll always be lovers. Walking through life, hand in hand.
What now, Bonnie?
Follow me, Clyde.
Easy, old man. We'll get a doctor.
Oh,
sickless chelk. Do you think he was trying to tell us who the killer was?
I don't know. But whoever he is, I think he's standing behind us.
I don't want to hear that.
Oh, turn around.
I don't want to hear that either.
Get up. Put your hands up.
Look, mister, whoever you are, we don't mean any harm to you.
No, we just dropped in to get our shoes greased. Almost got a permapress job.
Did you see who it was?
No, but I sure felt him. Hey.
What's that?
Well, it looks like it's off a spur. I think it's a rowel.
Maybe it came off the killer's spur.
Yeah.
I kicked him.
Right. Let's get to the sheriff. I think we really have something to tell him.
Left for dead, but recovered consciousness in time to see Dan and Sheila Bartlett leave the scene of the crime. And Sheriff Riley says there's no chance of them escaping. Roadblocks have been set up at all points leading to and from the area.
Now I'm wanted for three murders.
Can they hang you three times?
Sure, but the second two are just for laughs.
Why are we slowing down?
Well, I can't give myself up to that sheriff. You won't believe anything I tell him.
You're right. We'll have to hide until we can think what we can do.
That's why I'm going to call John Ed.
While we were fighting with the killer, this came off his spur.
A rowel.
Looks like it was made from a Mexican peso.
Appears that way. Looks like our killer works on a ranch. I'll have my hands check the ranches in the morning, see if they can come up with the owner of this.
Well, shouldn't you have the sheriff do that?
It's better if we have an airtight case first. Why don't you two stay here tonight? You can use the guest room down the hall.
Well, good evening.
Hey, here's a bit of luck. The Bartlett saw the killer. He was wearing this.
Did you get a good look at his face?
Only a glimpse, really.
Well, now, if you could give us a description of him, maybe we could give the sheriff a picture of the man he's looking for.
Well, he was big and powerful and dark, wasn't he, honey?
It sure was, with a moronic face and a weak chin.
And little pig eyes. And the sloping forehead of a born criminal.
I'd hate to think that he was at large.
You two must be bushed.
I could use a hot bath and a soft bed.
You'll find everything you need down the hall on the right.
Oh, thanks.
We won't forget you for this, John Ed.
Good night.
Bye.
Have a good night.
Bye.
Every cowpoke in this section of the country knows about you and your Mexican spurs. If those two ever start talking to the sheriff...
They're not going to talk to anybody. Look, nobody knows they came up here. Don't worry. It's gonna be nice and peaceful.
How about another round of drinks, Sheila? I'm buying.
Oh, I've had enough. Haven't you?
Nah, liquor makes you smart. Nothing like a little blast to give you a clear picture.
How'd she do that?
Here I am fighting to stay alive so I can enjoy the happiness of life. And what is my life? I fight freeways, I breathe carbon monoxide, I sell tummy tones to people who aren't really sick until after they've taken them. And then I go home and fight with my wife.
Why don't you come over here? Get some of that nice, cool, fresh air.
That's why I want to stay alive. So I can enjoy all this happiness. That's the important thing. Joy.
Honey, we haven't been fighting since we came out west.
We've been too busy running.
We didn't start out fighting.
We sure didn't. We had a lot of good stuff going. A little hanky paint. I like the way we put it all together. You know, like you'd stay home and I'd go to work and support you. Then I'd come home and you'd be dressed real pretty. Or better yet, undressed real pretty.
I think I'll have that drink. Oh, you haven't done that since our wedding night. I'll just be a second. Honey, you don't really think I tried to steal your show?
What difference does it make? You'll have it all after they hang me.
Dan, don't talk like that. You have a long life ahead of you. You know it.
Ah, who wants it? You know why a baby cries when it's born? Because it suspects what's ahead of him. How does a baby get his first breath, Sheila? Doctor slaps him on the rump, and then on it's just one kick in the pants after another. That's why I never became a doctor like I wanted to. Because I couldn't stand the sight of blood. I never got to be a movie star because the first day on the set, I got appendicitis. Richard Burton got the part. You know what happened to him. All I got was tummy tones and you. Boy, that's room service.
Dan, you gotta get out of here.
Shh. Now.
Reese is trying to kill you. What are you talking about? It's true. I just saw him throw a knife through the window.
A knife? That's good enough for me. Let's tell John Ed.
No.
Whoops, wrong door.
All right. Let's move. Through the window.
The window?
Shh. Through the window. All right, hurry it up. Listen, you be nice and quiet.
Oh, I'll be quiet. This is the loudmouth. Shh.
Everybody out of the car. This is where we say goodbye.
Fine. Goodbye.
All right, hold it right there and shut up.
Come on, Reese. Where's your sense of humor?
Well, I'm going to get a big laugh when the sheriff finds the three of you dead. Now up behind that shack. Move it.
Look, Reese, you can't get away with murder.
Right. My daddy was a detective, and he always said that. Of course, nobody found out who killed Daddy, but you may not be so lucky.
Yeah, you'll be a fugitive. How long can you be a fugitive? He only lasted 3 years on television.
All right, right up behind that shack. Turn around. All right, now turn around. Face me right over there. All right, this is the end of the line.
Let's not part now. We're just starting to enjoy your company.
Yeah, well, you know what they say. Two's company and three's a shroud. Yeah, I heard that on one of your shows.
If you did, I deserve to die. Look, hold it. Hold it. I've never been shot before. It's upsetting my stomach. Do you have any tummy tones in your bag?
Tummy tones? tones?
Yeah, you know, right next to your hairspray.
I'm gonna fill you so full of holes those tummy tones will roll out.
Yeah, well, forget about me, but at least let my wife fix her face. You know, she's a television celebrity, and she wouldn't want to go looking the way she does.
What's wrong with the way I look?
Well, you're all right for being alive, but, you know, after you go, you'll need a little extra color, and you want to fix your hair?
All right. And the newspapers will want pictures, and I wouldn't be caught dead looking like this.
Well, that's exactly how you're going to be caught, all right.
Oh, just a little lipstick.
Here! You be careful what you take out of that bag.
Lipstick? Hairspray? See? I think we've given him the slip.
Yeah, but he might slip back.
Hide out in that cave. Our only chance is for me to get to the sheriff.
Yeah.
It's cold in here.
I can't see a thing. Ow!
Exactly the water.
Get your mother out of the house.
Oh, crazy, help!
Crazy, help!
Fred, she can't do that. She's all tied up at the moment.
You get us out of here!
Oh, if I did that, I'd have to shoot you. And I'd be a fugitive like you said. This way, it'll look like you just ran into a little bad luck trying to get away from the sheriff.
Boy, I take it back. He doesn't have a sense of humor.
Must have bypassed our roadblock somehow.
They're probably across the border into Mexico by now.
Well, if we don't get them, the water will.
Are you giving up, Sheriff?
Not Houndtooth Riley. Maybe they're lost up back country there somewhere. You call John Ed and tell him we got to use his helicopter.
Good idea.
Call John Ed!
What are you looking for?
Breakfast. I just remembered I might have something else in here to eat.
That's right. We ate all the tummy tones for dinner, huh?
Dan, would you like some wild raspberry?
Cough drops?
No, lipstick.
I don't like the taste of lipstick, unless it's on your lips.
Yeah. You haven't said anything that nice to me in a long time.
This is the first time we've been alone for a long while without 30 million people watching us. What are you smiling about?
Something Crazy said. Dan, look. Food. A jelly bean.
A red one. My favorite.
You take it, honey. You're bigger than I am. You need more nourishment.
Nah, what good will it do me? If I get out of here, they're going to convict me for murder anyway. Go ahead. It'll be good for you.
Candy's not on my diet.
Well, we'll split it. You got an electric knife in there?
I think I have a nail file.
It's not a bat, it's a crow.
Where did he go, Dad?
Well, there must be an opening around here. A crow that gets in must get out. Give me your light.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Huh?
Careful. Hey, look at this. What'd I tell you? There must be an opening at the other end.
Hey.
Follow me. Hey, look. Look in here. Here. Hey.
What are you doing, Dan?
I'm clearing this out so we can see. Hey. That's a small tree.
Oh.
Boy, if we could just crack this open. Oh. Solid granite.
Oh. Only a crow could get in and out of here.
Hey. There's a crow's nest.
What are you looking for?
Just our luck. No eggs.
There must be some way to get through here. No.
Twiggy couldn't get through there, even if she skipped breakfast.
It's a plane.
Yeah. No, it's a helicopter. If we don't get rescued, at least we get the traffic report. Down here!
We're here!
Hey! Look over here! We're in here!
Well, they sure didn't use this trail. Not a sign of
them. There's only one other trail of the Mexican border. It's further west.
Let's go, Cactus!
Look at a sheriff with such lousy eyesight. Expect to catch a criminal like me.
Oh. Hey, give me your shoe.
My shoe? What for?
I saw an old Chaplin movie once where he ate his shoes.
Must have had better teeth. What are you doing now?
Looking for another jelly bean. If we could lure that crow back in here, we could hit him over the head with that stick.
I don't think I have strength enough left to knock out a crow. Sheila. Sheila, you didn't tell me you got another parking ticket.
Oh. I was afraid to.
Yeah, but this is 6 months old. You could go to jail for this.
Jail. Jail. Dale. Oh, Dale.
It goes 10 years. Wow.
Can you imagine the big fight we would have had about this in New York?
Yeah, then you'd ask me to take care of it for you.
And then you'd say, don't bother me. I've got problems of my own. Now we got the same problem. We're both going to die.
Oh, come on, don't be silly.
We are going to die, and I'm going to die a criminal because I owe the city $9 for a parking ticket.
Oh, don't worry. They can take it out of our estate, and you'll go clean.
Estate? I never gave you anyone to leave our estate to.
Sheila, will you stop blaming yourself?
Well, I've been a rotten wife. I didn't give you a baby. I horned in on your show.
No, you didn't. No, I was selfish. You got a right to do your own thing. Besides, you make enough money to pay your own charge accounts.
Well, I haven't been happy. I just wanted to be free, but that didn't mean free of my husband.
Yeah, well, you're not free of me. I love you.
Do you?
I guess I haven't shown it much.
I really didn't want your show. I just wanted to be with you.
The way I've acted this past year, I'm surprised that anybody'd want to be with me.
Well, I love you, Dan. Easy, Dan. You don't have enough strength to knock out a crow.
It's more fun. No, I've got something else in mind.
Dan, give me my Dan.
No, let me. Ah! Oh, boy. Ah! Ah! Yeah, if this works, I'll buy you a bag of jelly beans.
We've covered this area already. Looks like they gave us a slip, Sheriff.
Now, how could they have beaten us to the border by foot?
They could have doubled back to their car and made the getaway.
I think I can start a fire.
How are you going to do that?
Well, I'm going to shoot this arrow out through that hole. All I need is something flammable to put on the end of it. Sir. Hey, pardon me, buddy. I need this more than you do. Okay. I think we're ready to try it. Wait a minute. Okay, light it.
Got it. Hey. Dan, it caught fire. You're a genius.
Yeah, let's hope they see it or I'll be a dead genius.
All right, let's go back to the ranch.
Hey, look, Sheriff. Isn't that fire down there?
That's near the cave. It must be hard now.
Well, it looks like we got us our killer.
Yeah, we also got him for starting a fire in a no-smoking area.
Let's take a look.
Hey, they've seen it. They're going to land.
Oh, Dan.
Oh, boy. You're finally going to be a liberated woman.
Oh, thank God I didn't burn my bra.
Swallow that hogwash about Reese.
I do. You know those Mexican spurs Reese has? They dropped one of them in the garage in the fight with Mr. Bartlett.
Why didn't you tell us that that round belonged to Reese?
Well, Reese is an ex-con. I've been given a chance to go straight, and I had to be real sure.
Well, what was Reese's motive?
Stop asking damn fool questions, and let's get after that killer. He's got my stepdaughter.
Well, all right, John, but where do you suggest we look first?
There's a deserted lying shack by the river south of here. You might be holed up there.
Hey,
safe where you take your last big drink. I always did tell John Ed that you weren't polite to your elders.
I'm giving her mouth-to-mouth resuscitation.
That's okay, thanks.
Anytime. I'll go over the helicopter and see if I can get a blanket.
Nobody's going to that helicopter except me.
I guess this is it, baby. About to kill the Bartletts.
John Ed, you son of a... Strawberry, Indian land. Indian girl found map. And John Ed...
What does he mean by map?
Isn't it a shame we can't ask him?
Hurry up, come on, you don't want to miss your plane.
Stan and I want to have these.
Oh, Sheila.
Yes?
Hey, you use the house anytime, but be sure and lock up so only live people can get in.
Thanks. I can't live with John Ed anymore. We can't prove it, but for my money, he's as guilty as Reese.
Hiya!
Hey!
I come to give you an official escort to the airport. No hard feelings.
No hard feelings. And just to prove it, I'm not suing you for defamation of character until I get back to New York.
Well, and Mr. Bartlett, even the best of us make mistakes.
And you're not even the best.
Well, I gotta admit one thing, you know, you two are pretty good for amateur detectives.
We found everything except where the map is hidden.
If there is one, John Ed still claims there isn't.
Well, I'm gonna keep looking. They don't call me Houndtooth Riley for nothing.
Sicklish choke.
Oh, now, Miss Bartlett, there's no reason to cuss me out. I'm sorry.
Oh, no, that's what old Bear said before he died. I wonder what it means.
Well, I think it means gun up.
Why would he say that?
Hey, so we could miss the plane if we keep thinking about it. Come on, we gotta make it out of there.
Go.
Hey. Gun up. Why did old Bear want to tell us that?
Barrel, strawberry, gun up.
Gun up. Gun up.
Hey! Hey, wait a minute.
Wait a minute, what's wrong?
Gun up.
Hey, what you doing with that gun?
Hey, now, Mr. Bartlett,
Dad,
take it easy.
What is it? What did you find?
You know, if you don't hurry, you're going to miss your plan. What's that?
Hey. Hey. It's a map. Oh. It's a map in the barrel of the gun up over the fireplace.
Oh, Dad, Daddy would be so proud of you.
Yeah, that's a map, oh. All right.
And what a map. It shows that almost all of Strawberry is Indian territory. And John Ed knew about it all these years.
Oh, me and John Ed are going to have an interesting little talk.
I want to be there. I'll meet you at the ranch right after I take Dan and Sheila to the airport. Come on. Oh.
Sir. Hey, New York's going to look mighty peaceful after the rest we've had here. Well, our time is about up. Have you anything to say, darling, before you say goodnight?
Yes. This will be my last show.
What?
I'm quitting.
Oh, you're putting me on. You have a contract.
Yes, but there is an out clause in my contract.
Yeah, but the only out clause is an act of God.
Or my husband.
You mean I... We... You and me? Is that what you mean? How about that, folks? Never mind, we'll walk.